Hey, today is Sunday, a little quiet day. How you say quiet day? Here with my grandkids. I wanted to, my daughter finish my hair, but she has to attach another piece on so I can have my little, you know, my little long braid in the back. So, I was on the YouTube and I was looking at some of the laptops and stuff. Now, the laptop design that I have designed through the years, I've been working on different, HP, they got HP, they got Windows, they got Windows XP 2000, Windows 99, Windows 95, or whatever. But I've been working on my own Windows. But mine is called the Cloud, and the Cloud is I create social different apps for the Cloud, and you have different. But it's through a cloud. It's through a cloud window, you know. Windows is Windows. It's through like a tower, you know. But the cloud is through actually a cloud is that you know how you do how they cloud creates. On rainbows, so it's like a cloud creates apps, you know what I'm saying, and it's a reflection on how you put your windows, so you're not really connected to, you know, an actual worldwide web. You're actually connected to a cloud database command center, which meaning that they get to see all of the apps that I create for the cloud. And you click on the ones that you want to activate. And the ones that you activate is in the price, you know, you're downloading. So these apps is ran through your phone number and your... your phone number locates the apps. So say like you want another social media on there, you download the social media, but it's automatically connected to your phone number, and that social media automatically creates a social media page for you, so they'll know your location of your social media and through that number. But someone's been changing up my numbers and my location. So, being that it might be a couple of people in my family that's probably young kids being customer service. But you have to create a whole internet service for your internets. Like database, you have to create a whole computer programming database for all your devices, and these devices, these network services goes on a device that is compatible to the cloud, you know, and the cloud is the only is compatible to the devices that Z Technology creates, which is me. Z Technology. I learned Z Technology creates the devices, so the devices has to have some type of window to have access to the internet, you know what I'm saying? So you could create a cloud cloud tower, and you can get social media, but you can get like person to person video, person-to-person call, and stuff like that. And it's like a community. It's like a community that you create. You can create. And they actually have Snapshot. It's similar to Snapshot, but it's called Tango. So I created Tango, But I also created Snapchat also, but it's through like young social media. So we have a lot of kids. My daughter wasn't allowed to go on like a lot of pages. I had blocked her, but she was able to go on like Disney. She was able to go on like certain children social medias, you know, making dolls and stuff like that. You know how you it's called doll fashion. And with on this website, I think Disney created this one, but she was able to create those, create her own style on doll fashion. I think it's called dollfashion.com, but this was years ago. This was in 2006. So you might be able to find it, because this was a long time ago when she was only 11 at the time. So, and then she was on fashion, Barbie Fashion House. I think the other one was called Barbie's Closet. And, those social media she was only allowed to go on when she was young. And she can share her fashion with people on Facebook that signed up for kids. Facebook is a kids Facebook that they designed. I don't know if they still have it, but she's grown now, so she's on the, I think she's on the grown people page. But they created a kid zone for the Facebook, you know, young social media, and she was able to do a lot of designing for different websites, her websites. And she did a little bit for me too, but I had learned how to do mine through basically learning from my niece Octavia. She showed me how to like download to search for like downloading and creating like radio station. But I learned by accident how to create my own radio station, the music that I like. So I'm, like I said, I'm an LLC and I write music and stuff. I write lyrics and stuff. So I'm the recording lyrics LLC. So I created a radio station where that I can create a radio station within my own email. And through that email, if someone likes it, I had Yahoo. So if someone wanted to request for a radio station, I would send them my radio station network, and the radio station network, they can listen to all of the new songs that I upgrade. But it's like they downloading it, they become a person of interest of hearing the music that I create. So but for some reason, I got blocked out of the internet, period. I guess everybody was making a fuss out of something that they didn't really understand what I was doing. So I guess they was trying to block me to get an understanding of what I was doing, so they can, I guess, mock everything that I was doing and coming into the business and stuff like that. But I was already, my nephews and them was already doing their thing. So I don't know about the writing or anything, but I've been doing this for a long time. So so I don't know what type of animosity that the church had against me. But I'm finding out. I'm finding out a lot. But I don't have no hate for them, you know. Sometimes you don't. Some people don't understand you. And it was the same way. Jesus didn't, he warned us. He said, because of my name's sake, they will, persecute you and lie on you and, set you up and all this stuff. You know, go in front of a group of people and say this. But they attacking me through the social media and stuff like that. So I guess they figured, well, this is a worldwide web, and what more to attack her from is from social media. But that's okay. While they was attacking me, I was lifting them up. I don't like the devil, so I don't like doing the work for the devil. So what I like to do is just make the devil more madder by going after that soul that he got. You know what I'm saying? So any type of person that is trapped go. Any type of move, Emmy. I mean, El Sky. That any type of person that is trapped in doing the work of the devil, you know, I'm a, you know, Jesus tried all he can do to try. Hey, go back over there. Go back over there. Stop telling me shush. If I put you in the hallway, okay. So he was telling her father, probably whispering in her ear, talking about tell Grammy to shut up. And I'm gonna give Khalil a haircut if he don't stop. He don't stop messing with me. Okay. I told the devil, you know, I told God I'm gonna work for him from now on. You know what I'm saying? So those that attack me, I still have to do my best in front of them, because the simple fact that if they see that I'm not backing down to the devil, the devil ways, then maybe they'll see some type of hope in the way that I live my life, that God still has something in plan. You know what I'm saying? Regardless of who's trying to like wrap their chains around you. I wrote a song called Breaking the Chain. You know what I'm saying? So a lot of things has come up against me, but it's for a good thing. It's not for a bad thing, because it's to show that when I stood up in the church and I said, believe everything that proceeded out of God's mouth, I had to stand on that, what I believed in. I didn't budge. You know what I'm saying? I still kept going. You know, everything that attacked me, I still stood on what I said in those churches. You know what I'm saying? And I'm still believing in that, and I'm still letting people know that. See, the devil said, oh, where's your God now? See, when Jesus was hanging on the cross, the priests came and said, where's, you know, he can save everybody else, but can he save himself? So a lot of people say, oh, she's going here and she's going there. Where's her church? Where's her house? Where's this at? Where's her car? But those are just material things. You know what I'm saying? Those material things that God can take away at any time. You know what I'm saying? He said, do not put anything or anyone before me. So to put a car before God, you know, put money is still an object. You know what I'm saying? It's an item. So he said, I am not an idolized God. You know what I'm saying? I'm not a graven image. So an image that you see on that dollar bill, he said, in God we trust. That's what is it? Washington on the bill, you know? And you figure he's the idolized God, idolizer. You know what I'm saying? So look at the person that's on the dollar bill. Look at the person that's on the $10 bill, the $20 bill, the $50 bill, and the $100 bill. You know what I'm saying? So look at all of those persons. And he said, they do not worship me, the things of me. They worship the things of idolized gods. So look at the person that they have. He said, when he did about the money, he said, give to what God is God and give to what Caesar is Caesar, right? So what they doing is when you are doing things of God, but he said, in God we trust. Now the man said he trusted God, but the government, you know what I'm saying? If the government is trusting in God's ways, so if the government is watching and saying, hey, this person is really for God, you know what I'm saying? We're going to trust in every word this person say, because we dedicated this money to God. And you know what I'm saying? So I understand the government standpoint, and I understand man's standpoint, you know what I'm saying? The citizens of America, you know what I'm saying? I understand the citizens of America's frustration, and I understand the government frustration, and everybody is trying to find a common ground, and with that common ground we can find it in the word of God. You know what I'm saying? So I just wanted to share that with everybody. Okay, all right, see y'all later. Lisa Holmes, SkyDream Lyrics Production.